Hey everybody, how are you? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Welcome to Facebook Live. So if you're brand new to my world, if you don't know who I am, if you want to know why is this guy showing up in my Facebook feed, a lot of people share my Facebook Lives, and thank you so much. I feel honored and blessed that you do that. My name is Jeff Gellman. I'm with Solid Canine Training. We are an aggressive and behavioral modification rehab facility based in Providence, Rhode Island. I personally travel the world doing dog training seminars geared towards actually dog owners, and I also have a seminar series with a couple of my colleagues called Training the Trainers, geared towards dog trainers. We work with aggressive dogs, behavior modification. We do also young little puppies. We actually just started doing a trick training class. So we do a little bit of everything with the dogs. But our specialty is aggression rehab. I just put out this little YouTube video, and I actually want to make some commentary on it because a lot of people, it's only been up for 3 hours. It's going to actually be probably a huge video on YouTube. The reason is because it's sort of funny, but it's serious. We take aggression dogs extremely seriously. That's our specialty. But as somebody that works with aggressive dogs all the time, there are lighter moments. And a dog lunging into one of my trainer Spencer's crotch at the handoff, it's sort of a little bit funny, at least in my world. And if you haven't seen it, I'm going to show it right now. I'm going to show it right now, just so you can see what I'm talking about. Let me just turn the camera around. All right, let me just show you this. So you'll be able to see this. So this is on our YouTube channel. And it's also, oops. Oh my God, I guess I monetized it. Didn't realize I did that. And then I'm going to give some commentary. Okay, so, boom. And watch this in slow motion. Ready? Nails him right in the crotch. Okay, so. Okay, so a lot of people see that and they're going, you know, wow, that's intense. Oh my gosh. Good thing the dog was muzzled. All this other stuff. So, number one. Just to put everything into context, because I do a ton of social media. We Periscope our training sessions. We're balanced trainers. We use food. We use clickers. We use remote collars. We use prong collars. And there's always this fascination with people that like to bash tools, which is fine. This is not what this is about. But just to clarify, that dog that you just saw, who thankfully had a muzzle on, and literally muzzle punched Spencer, one of my trainers, in the crotch, and if it didn't have a muzzle on, it would have actually chomped down on it. So just to put that, and that was at the handoff. So that was at the owners were giving us the dog, and they're usually stressed anyway. No matter what, you know, they're always distressed. It's like, here's the dog, we take him into the back. But just to scale, that's an average dog for us. Like, that was actually no big deal. I just put it up on YouTube because I actually thought it was a pretty funny moment. No disrespect to the family, no disrespect to the dog, and no disrespect to Spencer. But it was a little bit of a funny moment. But I think it's important that people out there in the dog training world and people that like to bully other dog trainers like myself, which doesn't bother me just a way, but bully other dog trainers like myself with their armchair quarterback type, well, you should do this, you should do this, you should do this, would never touch a dog like that. They wouldn't. So a lot of times people see dogs behaving on our property, like they're doing things nice, and they're like, wow, what a cute dog, and that dog is so friendly looking, and the dog doesn't look aggressive. Because why? Because we're training the dog. I think it's important to understand that that's how that dog, all those dogs started like that, though. So that dog was literally handed to us in that condition. So most of the dogs you see, like today there's this bulldog on our Facebook page and our Instagram page who would attack us. It's like a 90-pound bulldog that would attack all of us at the training center. So I think it's important that people understand, that's why we show so much of our work, of the kinds of dogs that we deal with. So this isn't an ego brag, but 99% of dog trainers in the United States wouldn't touch a dog like that. And again, this is not like, oh, look at us, we're so great. It's that that's just our everyday dog. Like all the dogs that we deal with, pretty much, except for some of the young puppies, they're like that. They do that stuff. They don't necessarily nail us in the crotch, but they try to bite our faces. They absolutely go for extremities, which are arms and legs. They bite us to cause harm. They attack our dogs. They get into dog fights that if we didn't stop, we'd prevent them. But if we weren't able to prevent them and stop them, they would possibly kill another dog. So these are dogs that we deal with. So when you see a dog like that, and then you're going to see tomorrow, I'm going to go to the training center. Tomorrow, I'm going to go to the training center, and I'm going to Periscope that dog. So that video was taken yesterday. So today is Saturday, just to put everybody on a time frame. That dog came in Friday afternoon. Today is Saturday. Tomorrow is Sunday. Tomorrow, I will do a live Periscope of that dog. And you'll see the progress we're making. So I just want everybody to know and just to get it out there saying, a lot of times there's people don't show their work. So you usually see a dog doing well, but you don't understand why they've got certain tools on. And you're like, well, geez, why does it, the dog doesn't need those tools. Actually, yeah, it does. It actually does need those tools. And if there's any folks out there that have got this fairy dust fantasy that, well, if you did this, this, and this, the dog would like respond. Like, no, it wouldn't. No, it wouldn't. And then you can't use the excuse saying, well, if the owners would have done that. That's not, that's the past. Like, you can't change the past. Like, that's the dog that we have in front of us. You know what I mean? Like, so we are, that's the dog we're working with. We didn't have an option of what happened pre-Friday. That's what we got to deal with. So just want to let everybody know that I thought that was a really fun video. It sort of shows what we work with. And that was pretty cool, I think. I think it was great that we captured it. Anyway, so what do we got? It shows what you guys deal with. Absolutely. Grateful guys like you and the good dog. Awesome. Yeah, the good dog is great. Actually, Sean and Laura are going to be actually flying in tomorrow at about noon. Yeah, it has a muzzle. Yep, it has a muzzle on. Yep. The dog didn't come with a muzzle. The dog didn't come with a muzzle on. We actually put a Spencer actually, before he grabbed the dog, was like, we're putting a muzzle on that dog. You can always tell when a dog's going to bite you. Like, we do this a lot. So put a muzzle on. The dog actually will not be wearing a muzzle at all, anymore. So the dog is fine. Now the dog, it's always a little bit stressful for that. And we've got different ways. In fact, I can even show different ways for my fellow dog trainers how to handle aggressive dogs at the handoff. We've got so many different protocols how we could have done that. But putting a muzzle on the dog, putting a slip lead on the dog, doing the leash exchange, it's a little bit stressful for that one. Literally, that was a 4-second clip. But then it's fine. It's usually fine after that. The dog went back into the kennel area, got kenneled up. That afternoon, which was yesterday, there might be some photos. I got to check all the cameras. We use 3 different cameras at work. I got to check the cameras to see if there's a photo of Spencer just working that dog. So tomorrow, I'll work that dog tomorrow. And I'll go over what the protocols we're doing. And that'll be the first time that I will be handling that dog. All right. Hello from Southwest suburbs of Chicago. Awesome. I'm going to be actually in the Chicago area in April doing a seminar in Gilbert, Illinois. Thank you for your post. You're welcome. Yeah, you got to be careful. Yep, Jason. Yeah, I got a dog. Dog nailed him in the crotch. And he, yep, exactly. So that's it. Just wanted to say that. All right. Yep. We'll show you the work. We'll show you the work. We show all our work. All our work. We're 100% transparent. The only thing we don't show is if there was a dog fight, which we rarely have, even with dog aggressive dogs, us breaking up a dog fight or stopping a dog fight, that we actually can't show on Periscope, nor does anybody need to see that. Because we can probably get in trouble. That would probably break Facebook and Periscope's bylaws or whatever they call them about social media, that somebody can report that we're actually showing dog fighting, which is not allowed, even though it's not dog fighting, it's like dogs fighting. So I guess that is dog fighting, but it's not like we like, you know, we're placing bets and like there's like, you know, any of that stuff. Like there's not like a circle with dogs in it. All right. Take care, Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training, and madly in love with all of you. Proud of all of you. Great testimonial that's on my Facebook page from Slovenia today. Check that out. So it's a DIY testimonial, do-it-yourself testimonial. A woman in Slovenia fully off-leash trained her German Shepherd in less than a month. Couldn't even take the dog out in public. And it's off-leash trained. And she videotaped it and she sent it to me. And she wrote a great little testimonial. And she learned it for free on my videos. So no excuses, folks. No excuses. You don't have to hire me. You don't have to hire my company. You don't have to hire any dog trainer out there. You can learn it on your own, but you got to put the work in. So meanwhile, we need business. Like we don't need business. Like we make a living from like business, but you don't have to hire us. But people do, because that's how we employ everybody and pay the bills. All right. Awesome. I'll show you my dogs. People like to see dogs. Kira, girl, Kira, girl. People like to see the dogs. They're just like, hey, let me see your dogs. So there's two of them, and they're not tired. They're like in command. What command is that? It's the look tired command. It's actually place, and place means go to those little dog beds or any little dog bed and relax. So I've got a video on place. So you want to do that. Same here from the Netherlands, working on my Turkish Kengel through videos. Oh, awesome. I've got a Turkish Kengel as well. Elena. Yeah, I've got a, hey, Elise, how are you? I've got a Turkish Kengel Ronin. Yep. Do I run a tight shift with your dog? Yeah, I do. I mean, my dogs are sort of outside dogs. Like the only area of this, I'm in my office right now. This is my home office. The only area in this house they're allowed is actually in this room. And then they have a kennel. I've got my own little kennel that's attached to my house that my dogs live in and sleep in. And then there's outside, there's a small outside run of maybe, I don't know, 400, 500 square feet. And then there's a 2,500 square foot, big, huge run that they have access to as well. But these two dogs that are next to me, they pretty much are with me all the time, especially at work. So yeah, I run a pretty tight ship, I guess. But it's not like, get there right now. It's sort of like just expected behavior. Like they know what to do. Like I come up here and they just go there and I tell them, you know, good. So they know what to do. We just have a very structured day. And it's easy. That's the great part about it. You get to say yes. The great thing about having structure in your day with your dogs is you get to say yes a lot. You get to say yes a lot. And if for a bunch of people that are just tuning in right now, I'll show you that video one more time, and I just want to show it just so you people understand that this is like our average dog that we work with. This is like an average dog that we work with. I'll show it one more time because it's sort of the, and a bunch of people are just still signing in right now. So one more time. So this is a dog that just got dropped off yesterday. Yeah, you should. So, boom, this is the handoff. And look at that in slow motion. Bam. And he's muzzled. Woof. That's Spencer. He's the man. There we go. So anyway, I just thought we'd show that. Because that was a lot of fun. But I know, we take it seriously again. We take it very, very seriously. And it's not to be disrespectful to the family, the dog, or to Spence. But when you work with aggressive dogs all the time, it was good video. I thought it was good video. So we turned it into a YouTube video and we put it out there. All right. All right, everybody. Awesome night. Have a great night. Take care. If you see Linda online, wish her a happy anniversary because it's our wedding anniversary. So she's excited about that. So am I. Thanks. Take care. Bye-bye.